刚刚大家听了我们两次加速器的团队，包括那个边界和磨程，那大家一定也会很好奇，那加速器到底是怎么帮助这些团队来做具体的他们的一个创新的迭代。那首先呢，我先介绍一下我们的两位来宾。第一位呢是 Cosmos 的创始人 Jay， 对，还有一位呢是边界智能的创始人和 CEO 曹恒。那我先介绍一下 Jay。Jay 呢是2005年获得康奈尔大学计算机专业的学士学位，他曾经在硅谷的 Alexa 和亚马逊担任过软件开发的工程师，后面呢他在 Yelp 代理移动应用的团队开发。那他曾经为了解决比特币的软件上面的一个 bug 呢， Jay 创建了 Tendermint BFS 的这个共识算法。那 Tendermint 还有包括 Tendermint Core 区块链的引擎，那这个是在 POW 的共识算法之外创建的一个可靠的 POS 的算法。同时呢，这也是区块链领域的非常具有前瞻性的网络 Cosmos 的创始人。那 Jay 呢，他一直都是在美国生活和工作，所以接下来的部分呢，我们就会转成英文来进行。那来宾的话呢，可以通过桌上的同传来了解我们的一个进展。So I would switch to English, and I would first to ask Harriet to share with us how she get to decide to do a startup on blockchain and her experience with our chain-based accelerator.
Thanks, Tom. Yeah, actually, just to let you know, my English name is Harriet, and 我的中文名字是曹恒。Actually, why did I get started on blockchain? Well, I have been, actually, before I begin my startup life, I used to be working in IBM TJ Watson Research for more than 16 years. Have always been working on those data-heavy, analytics-driven systems. I have been very grateful, I had the opportunity to work with the greatest minds in the world to work on those challenging and innovative problems. But we have always been challenged by the difficulty, how to get the data. So that has been a challenge. And when I think back, actually at that time, we already start to use some really crude method, kind of implementing the method that I explained earlier, the distributed AI, and we are trying to get our model actually running in the sub-data sets, and then integrate that in a more global level, and then iteratively trying to improve our model accuracy. But only when I get to learn blockchain technology, I found that can be really a very good foundation to address the difficulties I have always been trying to address. Actually, I want to add one thing. I think to the blockchain technology, comparing with Jay and all the other speakers have been sharing their knowledge, I'm still kind of new. Actually, only last year, September, was really the time I get deeply start to dive into the blockchain concept and learning that. It has been quite heartwarming. In just 1 year, and the last year, with the sponsorship of Wanxiang. Actually, Wanxiang gave me the free tickets to come to this conference. I know it has been quite expensive. As a startup, we are quite poor. So they gave me the tickets. So for the 6 days, 3 days on Ethereum DevCon, and also 3 days on the Global Blockchain Summit. And that was the first time, actually, I heard about Tendermint. And last year, also on Demo Day, Jay and his team winning the most innovative award. So it has been very impressive and also quite been eye-opening. So that is why I decided this is a very interesting area and a very open area. We can definitely do some innovation here.
Yeah, so from Harry's story, we know that definitely be a very big decision to leave a company IBM to switch your focus area from AI, which is also a very hot innovation area, and switch to blockchain related. So what are the real, are there any real challenge you face?
Actually, I'm not leading the AI practice law. So what I'm really doing is extending it. And to really do that together and trying to make it more powerful so we are able to address the real world problem. In terms of the challenge, indeed, blockchain, like when I first learned the concept, I was so excited. I feel like I found the key. But when we really get the hands-on to the software itself, everything is so immature. Incomplete document is one thing, and sometimes even like incomplete code, you see the method, but when you get it, it's empty. So we have been trying to explore the different parts, and we tried Ethereum, and it was great. It was great. And so I really like the smart contract, the concept. However, it cannot really support the performance we need in the business application. So that's why like we get into the BitShare. However, the BitShare, although the POS, the DPoS implementation, like it is good, but it doesn't have the smart contract. So when we do this application, you need to hardwire a lot of things. And it was not really easy. So that is why we start to look into Tendermint actually in April. And so that is why like, we feel like that server like, actually provides some of the good basis to address the challenge we have. So it was not a very easy route. And I would be very thankful like, to the, all the help I got from Jay and his team. Of course, I was quite surprised as busy as Jay and your team. So you can like one way have ping you on the Slack, even get the answer from you and from Ethan Puchman. So and of course later the wonderful team members like Agent Brick, I don't know if he's in the audience, and helping us to install the Ethermint, so which is a EVM compliant and using the Tendermint as a consensus engine. So maybe you should ask Jay like how we have been bugging his himself as well as his team members with all those difficult challenges.
Yeah. So first, thanks for Jay for being our advisor for ChangeFace Accelerator team. Thank you. And even you got an Asian face, as I know, it's just your second time to come to Shanghai, right?
That's
it. And the first time is to attend our last year's global blockchain summit. So could you share with us how you and Cosmos Tendermint team to help a Chinese blockchain startup on their blockchain related innovation?
Sure. So I got excited about Bianjie because of the artificial intelligence component. And we've been thinking about what are the major infrastructure problems, architecture problems in the blockchain space. And I believe that bringing artificial intelligence, creating real-world applications using AI in a blockchain setting poses a lot of interesting problems. So that's why we're very keen on working with Ganje to create new protocols, new architectures. Mostly, we've been discussing initially on Slack, so getting meetings, but we've been moving on to WeChat, which is much better for these more intense discussions. At first, we discussed how to create a minimal viable product for artificial intelligence in the blockchain for Bianjie, given the limitations of current technology. For example, by using Ethermint, which is, as Harry mentioned, a combination of Tendermint and Go Ethereum. But what we're working on now, which is very exciting, is creating new infrastructure to bring service-oriented architecture onto the blockchain. So we call this smart service infrastructure. And the point is to enable scalability and privacy preservation for blockchain applications by creating bringing service-oriented architecture into the blockchain space. And we believe that by creating this new smart service infrastructure, it will make it much easier to create more complex blockchain applications like those that require artificial intelligence in a real-world business setting. So we're very excited to work with Ganje to, in this joint venture to create this market service infrastructure.
That's great. So do you have any plan to expanding, you know, for such a partnership with startups in China to let more team can benefit, you know, the advanced technology that the Cosmos and Tendermint team is developing?
Sure, of course. So given what we're trying to do which, with Cosmos, which is bring all these blockchain projects and enable them to scale, but also mostly interoperate, the best thing and the most important thing we believe we need to do is create a community of developers here in China. And so, as you know, a month ago we announced the Cosmos China community, and that was announced August 5th, a month ago, with the help of Banjing. And so I wasn't able to attend, but I want to use this opportunity to thank you for being a guest keynote speaker there.
It might be a pleasure.
Yeah. So there's a few things that we can do to help the blockchain community here, especially with the One China Group. Well, one is communications, to bring the Cosmos community together. We have a WeChat subscription channel, as well as a WeChat group. We invite you to everyone here, especially developers, to join us. And just yesterday, I learned about the Wangchang BBS forum. So this goes to show that Wangchang Group is very serious about being a global leader in bringing these blockchain ecosystem players together. And we're very happy to, very excited to be part of that. Of course, we're also running the Cosmos Hackathon. The second hackathon was announced during the opening ceremony, and very pleased to announce that more than half the members of the Cosmos Hackathon are based in China. So that's very exciting. By the way, speaking of developers, we are going to have a cruise party on Saturday evening. So if you are a developer, please come join us. You need a WeChat invite, so just come find me or any of our Cosmos team members, and we'll go get going on the 16th. And lastly, we're very excited to work more closely with the Wangchang Group and all the incubated projects, for example, by helping them learn about Cosmos and Tendermint. I mean, after all, it's, the whole point is to create a protocol for interoperability. So this is a great opportunity for us to refine our protocols and to make sure it's usable for everyone. And lastly, we're also very excited to help the Wangchang Group run a Cosmos Validator. And there's just so many ways that we can work together. So I'm very excited to work with the Wangchang Group and Yanji to bring about the new blockchain.
Yeah, thanks, Shane. Let me switch back to Chinese. 所以透过刚刚的这个分享呢，大家可以看到，这是一个真实的案例。那曹恒也讲到，他其实接触区块链呢，是从去年万象区块链的峰会，去年9月份的时候，他才第一次。 接触到区块链，那现在今年呢，他已经坐在台上，作为一个区块链的一个创业团队，跟大家一起分享他过去几个月取得的一些进步。那J和 Cosmos 团队其实也是去年第一次来中国，尤其J北美，然后呢参加了我们的这个峰会。那在区块链的这个世界呢，有很多神奇的事情都会发生。那本来。 两个原来的轨迹没有任何交集的人，那可以坐在一起，为这个区块链的，不管是在基础底层还是在应用层面的创新，大家可以跨越国界这样来协作。那这个呢，也是万象区块链我们一直致力希望去做的事情。未来呢，我们也会通过像漫云我们的万象区块链实验室、我们的咨询服务和加速器呢。 能够从产业、从这个创业团队以及从技术的层面，为区块链整个行业的发展做更多的贡献。其实刚刚J也分享了，后续的话呢，在万云的万象的万云平台上，那 Cosmos 的主链上线的时候呢，也会在万云平台上做一个部署，可以让我们国内的开发者呢，第一时间有机会直接参与到这个 Cosmos 和 Tendermint 这样的一个技术的社区当中。 未来的话还会有像 BBS 技术的论坛这样的一些活动在万云上面去展开。最后呢，这也是邀请大家 Cosmos 在周六的 周六的晚上 ，it's Saturday night, right?
周六晚上，然后呢，会有一个 bus 在这边接。不过刚才好像说的是 Tendermint Cosmos 团队特别喜欢 developers。我好像听他们内部在讨论说，希望是有 GitHub developers。当然我不知道这个是一个玩笑还是真的，但是呢，我的一个体会就是 Cosmos 团队真的是一个非常 open 的，而且对于一个技术呢，有着非常大的专注力的一个团队。然后也欢迎有更多的区块链技术爱好者能够一块加入到我们当中来。
所以我们也希望有更多的区块链的创新和创业者呢，也加入到。信链加速器的这个大家庭当中，在这里你们有机会获得像 Jay 这样的世界级的技术大牛的亲身的指导。这个是我们的一个今天分享环节，给大家的一个分享。Thanks Jay and thanks Harry again.
Thank you.
谢谢大家。
Thank you.